Boom, right there.
It seems like everybody and their mom is wearing Nike Dunks in 2021, so I figure, you know what? Let's go ahead and talk about it. Yo, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to a brand new video. Now, before this video starts, I wanna give a quick shout out to the sponsors of today's video. If you guys are in the market for a beautiful timepiece, make sure to check out Meister Watches. They have a bunch of crazy models. I've been rocking with this company for almost 5 years already. So if you've been debating on getting a watch or you have an old and digi watch that you're looking to swap out, definitely make sure to check out my family over at Meister Watches. The link will be down below in the description and it will have a discount code that will get you guys 25% off all of the watches on their site, including the ones that are already on sale. So make sure you guys check that out at the end of this video. Welcome, 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 welcome. This is a brand new background for you guys. I think it might be my first time using this background for a video. I could be wrong, I don't know. But today we are talking about the Nike Dunk. Oh, and before we start, I'm going for like a more laid back vibe. So, you know, your boy's just chilling in this chair. I was trying to figure out, you know, should I stand, should I sit? And I think we're good with the sitting position. So that's how we're gonna be chilling for this video. If you guys have been keeping up with all of the sneaker releases, it's very, very difficult to say that you haven't noticed the trend for Nike Dunks. Now, me personally, I've always been into the Nike Dunk models, especially the Nike SBs, but I feel within the last year or two, Nike has been really pushing the Nike Dunk colorways, especially in 2021. To start everything off, we have to talk about the origins of the Nike Dunk, how it first started and how it came to fruition. So let's talk about it. The Nike Dunk originally released in 1985 and the use for it was for basketball. Now, if you take a look at the silhouette, it almost looks like a variety of sneakers, and that's because the Dunk is a variety of sneakers. It's actually composed of four sneakers that take inspiration to create this model, which are the Air Force One, the Air Jordan, the Nike Terminator, and the Nike Legend model. All of these are very similar and Nike basically took certain parts, certain hits, and they created the Nike Dunk. There are three different variations of the Dunk model, which are the low, the mid, and the high. I personally like the high models just because that's what I grew up on, but you guys let me know what model you prefer. A lot of people prefer the lows. I haven't seen too many people rock mids, but again, let me know in the comment section down below of what you guys are feeling. One of my earliest memories of getting a Nike Dunk High was when I asked my mom for the $60 or $70 pair back in the day. This is before I even started collecting sneakers. And just me asking her to buy me $60 or $70 shoes was really, really like insane. It was a lot to ask for, especially back then. I remember we were at the Nike factory at the Great Mall and I saw this pair of Dunks. It was like a really nice midnight blue. It had white, it had black to contrast. I still have that pair till this day. And when I asked my mom if she would buy it for me, she said yes, and I was so stoked. I felt like I had the coolest shoes in school. And even just talking about that pair really brings me back. I was worried about creases. I was worried about heel drag, star loss, every single thing when it came to that sneaker right there. So I got a ton of great memories with the Nike Dunk model. And speaking of Dunks, as you guys could probably tell in the background, I do have a lot of Nike SBs. There is a little variation when it comes to the Nike Dunk versus the Nike SB. As I mentioned previously, the original Nike Dunk model was for basketball. Now, Nike SB started in 2002 and was created for skateboarding. Now, a lot of the Dunks that you guys see today are non-SB Dunks, which means that these models are a little bit more simple, more for the casual, everyday wear kind of person. But if you guys want to get a little spicy, take a look at the Nike SBs. Since this model is made for skateboarding, it comes with a really puffy tongue, which I feel is extremely comfortable in my opinion. Secondly, the insoles have much more cushion just because skateboarding has a lot of impact on your feet. So Nike went ahead and adjusted their sneakers to that need. On top of that, most SB Dunk models have a lot more cushion in the ankle area and in the collar. So that's pretty nice. And I think that's important when you're looking at Nike Dunks to purchase. If you guys want something more simple, go with the regular Nike Dunk. But if you're looking for more comfort and cushion, I would go with the Nike SB. Regardless of what you choose, SB or normal Nike Dunk, one of the greatest things about these shoes is that they last forever. And when I say forever, I mean forever. A lot of older shoes that we see nowadays, like the Air Jordans, have major problems when it comes to the midsoles and outsoles. Most of the Air Jordans utilize a different material for their midsoles, which is why over time they dehydrate, they get a little crusty, and they end up cracking or crumbling. But luckily for the Nike Dunk, they use a very, very, very strong and durable outsole and midsole combination that just lasts forever, bro. I guarantee you that you will not see any of them cracking or crumbling. Now, as shoes age, the glue ends up weakening and separating on certain parts of the sneakers, but what I like about the Nike Dunk model is that it has that stitching around the midsole, so even when the glue decomposes and all that good stuff, you still have the stitching that's going to hold that sole onto the upper of the shoes, and that's pretty cool. Now, if you haven't had a pair of Nike Dunks before and you're using this video as a guide to buying your first pair, I would recommend going true to size on these sneakers. I've been collecting Dunks for a very long time, and every single time I get a pair, I go true to size, and that hasn't failed me. Nike has been releasing a lot of women's colorways, so if you're interested in a women's colorway, all you need to do is add 1.5 to your men's size to get the women's size. All right, so for example, if I'm a size 10 normally, I will be a size 11.5 in women's. Quick pro tip. Another thing to consider when buying a pair of Nike Dunks is the price of them. Now, the suggested retail price usually fluctuates between low 100s, so maybe $100 or 110 bucks, which is pretty cheap considering that this is the hottest sneaker of 2020/2021. Now, that's the retail price. Most people aren't able to cop for retail. I've been trying to get Dunks for a minute just for retail, just to see if I could get them, and I haven't scored just yet. But for most people that aren't able to get them for retail, you could go ahead and shop on places like eBay, GOAT, StockX, or you could go ahead and check out your local sneaker store to purchase a pair of Dunks. Just bringing it back, I mentioned that I'm into more of the Nike SBs versus the original Nike Dunk model because Nike SBs have a bunch of different colorways that I feel are a little bit more playful, a little bit more creative, and take inspirations from different stories, designs, movies, etc., etc. So that's why I like Nike SBs a little bit more. If you guys are looking for more simple colorways, you know, very solid colorways that are easily wearable, I would check out the Nike Dunks. But if you want your shoes to look a little bit more crazy, check out the Nike SBs. Now, in terms of comfort, I'm not gonna say the Nike Dunk is the most comfortable model because it absolutely isn't. You think that the Dunk model deserves a spot up there with the most comfortable sneakers alive? I personally don't think so. If I were to rate the non-SB Dunk, I would go ahead and rate that at maybe like a 7 out of 10 in comfort. And if we're talking about the SB model that has the padded tongue and padded collars, I would go ahead and rate that one at a 7.5 out of 10. That's just my brutal and honest opinion though, but you guys let me know in the comment section down below. When you're looking for a solid sneaker that you can wear in any type of weather condition, leather is definitely it. Leather is much more durable than a lot of other materials like suede, nubuck, or even a canvas material. It's much easier to clean and is more likely to be stain resistant. And speaking of cleaner, if you guys would like to support the site, shopsotopia.com is where you could go ahead and purchase my sneaker cleaner. I got brushes on there as well as the solution. And if you guys want a discount, use this code right here. It'll take 20% off your order. Don't tell anybody though, that's just between me and you. With the popularity of Dunks, a lot of people are looking for different things to make their specific Dunks stand out from the rest. And I get this question in my DMs so many times, so I figured I would address it in this video. If you guys are looking for replacement laces, check out Lace Lab, or you could go ahead and check out Angelus Direct. I have codes for both of those websites. They're basically interchangeable. Like, they're the same company, it's just kind of branched off a little bit differently. If you guys are trying to ball on a budget, here are some of the Dunk models that I would personally like to recommend to you guys that aren't going for astronomical prices, because I know a lot of them are due to the popularity. So here are some of my suggestions. This is going to wrap up the entire video of the Nike Dunk. Again, there's so much information that I did not leave in this video just because I wanted to talk about prices, sizing, the variations between the SB models versus the regular Dunk models, etc., etc. It's just way too much to combine into one video, but I tried my best. If this quick user guide helped you guys out with the Dunk model or gave you a little bit more information, don't forget to smash the like button and subscribe if you guys aren't subscribed already. We're almost at 600,000 subscribers, so thank you guys so much. I do appreciate it. I'll catch y'all very soon for the next video. It's your boy Sneakerhead in the Bay. I'm out. Deuces. Shoo.